Saturday, Ladies' Day study of the character of Jesus. Remember both of those on the calendar. I do have some good news for our membership. We have a new older member. Danny Horton has met with the elders, and he has placed membership on the radio. Everybody knows, and we're glad to have him with us. Our worship will begin with the reading from God's Word. We're going to take the Bible and turn to Mark chapter 3, verses 1 through 12. Richard Daniel will read those verses.
Holy and awesome, righteous Father in heaven, we come to you this morning, gathered together, come to bow in reverence, and have thankfulness in our hearts. Father, you've been so good to us. You've heaped such blessing and abundance on us, Father. We thank you for that. And we may we be good stewards of your blessings and serve each other, serve our fellow man, and helping to spread the gospel to those who need it. We're thankful, Father, for Jesus, whose name is above all names, and through whom we have forgiveness of sins, and we offer this prayer this morning. It's our intent as we gather together this morning to worship you in spirit and in truth, and give you all glory and honor. Help us, Father, as we assemble here this morning to help consider how to stir each other up to love and to good works. Father, we're thankful for the leadership that exists here, this local congregation. We ask you to strengthen our elders and give them wisdom. We're thankful for the unity that we have here. Father, we ask you to help us to strive together to be peacemakers, to be motivated by love for our brethren, and help us to look to others' interests as being more important than our own. We pray that we would be a healthy body of Christ here, working together in harmony, looking for Christ, to Christ as our authority in all things that we do. Help us to stand firmly planted in your will, not turning to the right or to the left. We ask your blessing, Father, on our efforts and our plans as we edify and evangelize here, this congregation. There's many events coming up in the next month that we ask your blessing on. The beginning of the new neighborhood Bible classes, the upcoming ladies study, the weekend series about the life of Paul that will be led by Bill Hall, the youth forum, and the meeting next month with Paul Earnhardt. And Father, we know that there are preparations beginning for our vacation Bible school coming up this summer. But we ask that you would be with all those who are taking a part in the efforts and planning, and give them wisdom as they plan for these events. We pray that much success and good would come from them, and that many would be edified and built up, and that we would find those who were sincerely seeking you. Help us to teach in truth. We're thankful for all those that we're able to support as evangelists in other places, here and in other places. We ask you to strengthen each one of them and their families and the work that they do. There are many here of our number that have ailments at this time, and many of our extended family members. The list is long. There's so many suffering from the flu or other similar illness and chronic illnesses. We pray your blessing on them, a quick recovery, and strengthen them, and also for their caretakers. We're especially mindful this morning of Jasmine Brown and Melissa Reynolds' father, Bob Dunn, and Patty and Sandra Kindleball, and Stephen and his mother. Father, ailments in the flesh are frustrating to us, and we know that we'll all deal with them from time to time. We ask you to help us maintain our focus and our faith in you and Christ Jesus when we are weak in the flesh. Ask you to strengthen us. Father, now as we continue in our worship this morning, we ask you to give us this time free from distraction, of worldly cares, that we can offer our service unto you and be pleasing unto you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Song this morning will be number 523. Number 523, Our Body is Alive.
Yeah.
section of scripture that we refer to as the Beatitude, where Jesus gives a series of statements about those who would be blessed. Jesus says, "Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness." And it may be difficult for us to always fully understand this passage because most of us probably have never experienced true hunger and thirst for physical food. But the hunger and thirst here really refers to a deep desire, a desire that probably consumes our focus, consumes our mind and our heart. And it says it's a desire for righteousness. And I hope that this would describe all of us here today, or that we would at least be striving for this level of desire for righteousness or being right with God. In 2 Corinthians, verse 5, 2 Corinthians, excuse me, chapter 5, starting at the end of verse 20, Paul says, "We implore you, on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God." Verse 21, "For our sake, He made Him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in Him we might become the righteousness of God." So if we are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, which I hope we are, then shouldn't our desire for that only be matched by our gratitude and our thankfulness for the one who actually made it possible, the one who actually made us righteous before God? We should have that gratitude every day, especially as we approach this memorial feast. Romans 5 says we have peace with God through Jesus. We have peace with Him. We are right before God through Jesus Christ, who bore our sins. He made Him to be sin, who knew no sin, as the passage we just read says. Bore our sins, paid the price for our sins through His death on the cross. The verse I referenced in Matthew 5, verse 6, goes on to say that those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, that they shall be satisfied, or that they shall be filled, as some version said. Why would they be blessed? Why would these people be blessed? It's because that desire would actually be satisfied, would actually be filled through the atoning blood of our Savior Jesus Christ. Let's think on these things this morning. Have a prayer.
Would you bow with me? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your Son, most importantly. We'd ask that right now that we would focus our mind on Him, and that you would bless His bread as we partake. In your Son's name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Dear Lord, our Father in heaven, we thank you for this time that you've given us to give reverence to your Son's death on the cross, giving up his life, the ultimate sacrifice that I'll be. Please, let's take this in a manner that is pleasing to you. Your Son's holy righteous name. Amen.
Sing the word of the King of Kings.
We are the Lord.
this isn't a work of the visitors. This is a duty and responsibility of the members here, so we're not solicitating your funds at this time. But I would like to encourage the members in our giving, so I'm going to read a passage from Matthew chapter 6, verses 19 through 21. It says, "Do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, neither moth nor rust destroys, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." I think that the point of this passage is telling us to focus on things that are heavenly. Focus on things that are eternal and that will last. And I think we all know that the work that this church does is a work that is eternal and a work that lasts. You know, just a few weeks ago, the elders laid out for us a plan for at the congregational meeting for what the funds that this church gathers go towards. And I'd like for us to think about those things as we give this work. Think about the heavenly work that this church does. Think about things that are eternal and not in this world. Now give back.